Yeah, so on the pharmacy benefit side, just to start there, the formulary concept and preferred drug concept are critical to, sort of governing uptake. So getting that contract to become the preferred product, which in today's market is really around achieving the lowest net cost, is really critical. And that's done on a really large scale through a few entities that do a lot of the procurement on the pharmacy benefit side. Whereas on the medical benefit side, individual health systems, academic medical centers, for instance, and then large multidisciplinary practices or specialty-specific practices do their own procurement. So the splintering of the market is much greater, and providers have to think about what would be the best, really largely from an economic perspective, so lowest cost for them to inventory and then use across all of their patients and be able to bill for and receive reimbursement for across all of their patients. If it's a pure play and it's going through either benefit, then the adoption issues become more clear given that kind of framework. What becomes even more complicated is when there's both pharmacy benefit coverage and adjudication and medical benefit coverage and adjudication, and so you have both to contend with.